only a madman would take on this mission. Lucky they found me. Hey, Super Nintendo must be here one more time. Once again, I should have said. And I'm truly back now. It took me what felt like years. It's been about a year. since I had an upload of any sort. Anyway, I am playing on OG SNES hardware, wirelessly, using my SN30 Pro, as well as 8-bits to SN30 Pro, as well as their adapter for Super Nintendo, the retro adapter. So, we are going to have ourselves a good time. Well, maybe you are. I have not played this game in a long time. But I figure, what better to relaunch my channel than what got me on the map in the first place? Which is UN Squadron. This is my favorite shoot-'em-up of all time, man. Oh yeah. I should have adjusted my mic before I began, huh? Let alone having found my extension cord. Anyway, it'll be fine. So I finally got a new video recorder in. I forget precisely what the name is, but I will be posting a review on it soon, because as you can tell, the results are phenomenal. I will also be having a Scanline integrator coming in this weekend. So you guys will get that genuine Scanline CRT look that all old school files love. Don't get me wrong, this does look fantastic. I'm used to these Scanline things now. Working, newbie people. Ow! Let's just say I'm rusty. What happened? Right! My TV and its HDCP. That's right. Give me a moment. Thank you. forgot to switch it to my old school setting on the TV. So yeah, I had to turn the consumer electronic control off. And then switch it to my old school visual setting. Rather than just doing an individual review, I can just post up my whole setup. I still can't believe I died on the first level. What the poop? Ow. I'm a little embarrassed I did not find my SN30 that I normally have paired with my SNES. That should sound better. Unfortunately, the microphone that I use on my setup is no longer available. Hasn't been for years. But it's been with my setup for a long time. I'm a little embarrassed that I decided to clean up my YouTube profile because I really didn't need to. But I am thinking of erasing one certain video because it's just completely irrelevant. So where do you think I should go? Forest? Or the enemy air force? I'm willing to bet money on forest. Because I know for a fact I'm going to level up. Help me get there, huh? So subscribe if you haven't already. Ah, shameful plug instead. Anyway. I've got those. I've got a big time classic library, and I'm hoping to have four players sometime. You know the community nights I uploaded a while back? Those are back as well. I've been doing community nights without YouTube, but now that I have a new recorder,
That is no longer the case. You guys will be in on the shenanigans. You can count on it. Me to keep playing, let me know. I do plan on playing Pilot Wings in an Orthodox manner. So if you want to see upside down controller shenanigans, let me know. Blindfolded landing? Perhaps that can be in on it. Power's in your hands, ladies and gentlemen. I have returned. I am the entertainer. I want to know what would entertain you. This is old school in its series, so let's keep it old school. Anything, I'm going to save PSX on down. But not as obscure as Atari, Amiga, or Commodore, please. I don't have those. I can go is NES, but PSX is fair game, Sega Genesis is fair game, oh the humanity, oh wait, I don't have 350, alright, I went off on a tangent there, so if I sound a little stuffed up compared to usual, yeah, I am. It's allergy season. Sorry. Oh, yeah. I'm just glad to be back. And I'm more an extrovert than ever. For better or worse. Let's just say I've been around other extroverts too much, and I'm starting to forget. How interesting introverting can actually be. Then again, when I was a kid, I was forcibly introverted by my disability. If you don't know about Asperger's syndrome, then it's on the autism spectrum disorder. Autism spectrum, excuse me. Can't talk or concentrate on here at the same time. But there are going to be certain times where I will not see. The way it works for me is it makes things socially more difficult for me. I don't quite get along with people that would interfere with my mind, such as extroverts. But I get along with those people too. It's just they drain me a lot more quickly. I'm a lot more serious and studious, so it can be a little bit hard for me to get along with some people like my coworker Mike. I will not state the last name. It is in his best interest. I do not. I like him, but he drives me crazy. Yeah.
okay, so now I have enough for an A10. But is that what I really want? Ladies and gentlemen, we have just had an SNES goes berserk moment. Ouch.
Alright, I'm going to reset the console. Hang on.
Q-tips to clean this bad boy off. Alright. Technical difficulties? Stand by. Pain in the behind.
This is one of those moments where I wished I was using my SNES Mini instead, but at the same time, it doesn't perform as well. Yeah, I should be doing a more casual run of this game, so I'll stick with normal. That phrase, even able to fly the most damaged plane, that's a reference to the opening scene of Area 88, where Greg flies in a broken plane, and much to the shopkeep's dismay, just takes Sonic back off immediately. He's a cheery lad at that one. Aw, man, I've been watching a little bit too much of Wing Commander. Got me. I started using some Scottish terms. Funny my name is actually from Scott. It's fine. I mean, if you look at some of my really old videos, you look cool. But let's just say I'm too fast. Don't even spoil the fact that Scott's are. Poor man. Back to my Asperger's syndrome. It gave me a serious back for like 5 minutes. Not gonna lie, that really helped. Make it back. In fact, video games were.
Excuse me, microphone fell. In fact, video games were the reason why I was able to connect with people. Up until finally I became an adult, basically. And it still is a way for me to show who I am. I mean, I love this game. Like, man. Just like the creator of the Bullet Heaven series,
I'm a huge fan of this game. I think it was way, way, way ahead of its time, and it still looks phenomenal today. Ah, forest or that. Considering it's only normal mode, I think I can take the chance. Excuse me again. And I need to get an extension cord for my microphone.
That was a pickle.
That was such a dill pickle, boys.
Hey, girls.
Oh, excuse me.
Operating on 4 hours of sleep. Let me grab a Coca-Cola.
So, this is the one serious drawback of recording on the fly. I'm not really an editing kind of guy at all. Never really believed in it.
I'd rather just be playing as if I were sitting in the same room as you, the viewer.
Chief.
light sensitive. That's more like it.
When I was a team, I realized that I could use this the opening of this game as an inspiration quote. Only a madman would take on this mission. Lucky they found me. Well, I've always felt myself to be a madman for taking on the world as someone with an NFC. Yeah. Your F-14. As much as I love the A-10, I'm starting to get a little burned out on that. Like playing as Shin, but I do have this case to make.
every character will eventually level up fully. Every one of them.
And considering the fact that you generally don't get the better planes very early, like even before halfway through the game, why the bleep would you play as Shin? At all. He takes the longest to recover, but he levels up very quickly. So your power level just flatlines halfway through the game. Come on! That's no fun! Alright, I used to call using the free cheating. Well, if that's the case, I'm a cheater today. Up, up, down, down, left, right, VA start, biatch. Let's go. Microphone again, man. That should work. Defeated. across the game ratio would not be good enough for me. Especially those who do like a more credit run. Personally, I don't really care for playing Mame. As you can tell, my favorite is Gray, because I am a clumsy son of a gun sometimes. Not only does he have the fastest recovery rate, but even when he's down to the lowest, down to zero HP, if you crash once, you're fine. Just don't do it again. So yeah, that gives me a lot of MOE. Besides, Greg rocks beer like me. Exactly what lines to use in order to just flawless everything. Up to the third set of levels, anyway. All I needed was Vulcan, and I could try to beat every single enemy. No greater pedigree. But, as it turns out, that was a mistake. Because I could have been getting more money from the weapon power-ups. Go figure.
Crusader can't pick up extra weapons for the darn, I tell you. I should not take that one out yet. Now behind there is a weapon pickup. I mean a money pickup. Take a little extra tour of the damage I have inflicted upon my foes. And the foes of the world, apparently. So what I understand of this particular version of the game is it follows a little bit more closely the anime itself. And it contains what was supposed to be the original ending to Area 88. I could be mistaken. Do let me know if I'm wrong about the latter part. Hey, that's one end, baby. Okay, screw this place hard. This is my most hated level in the game. It's also the first third level that I ever had to look and try at back when my dad was still a part of my life. Dad, if you ever manage to hear my YouTube channel, comment down below. I miss you very, very much. Phenomenal. We're on great track. No pun intended. Give me that shield. Crush. Okay, it's normal. We might not need it now.
I have no words. Okay, I do. I blew it. I blew good RNG right there. I received a second chance. Using the ceiling missile, thinking that was the only solution to that particular boss fight.
I was a fool.
Thank you.
here goes again. Just me not being willing to adapt to it, having to shoot upwards. I hate that boss! I do! And yet I love the ingenious design! Shows a crap ton of variety. I have no need for those bonus ships right now. I don't plan on failing that one. I don't plan on failing at all. Total cheese when fighting that final boss. I just want to win, man, so I'm gonna cheese it.
final level. Get this particular picture in your mind. I have a story to tell. Alright, so when I was a kid, like, maybe 9, I dreamt that I was in my mom's bedroom playing this game on what was basically a projector, without a projector actually being. And apparently I was playing the final level. I did not know it was the final level, but I was going through this exact section. I shite you not. This was before I even ever saw this final level. This is exactly where that dream cuts off. But yeah, kind of crazy. I prophesized myself to have beaten this game. Felt like the biggest accomplishment of my life. I was wrong, but it still felt incredible. I thought the icing on the cake was the game calling me crazy in the credits. That was awesome. I thought that was funny as shite. Cause I had to be crazy to go gamer mode. Forcing me to take another loop because I didn't nail all the guns. not that much of a disaster. I've already gotten over it. Thing about me, the difference between now and me 2 years ago. I just pretty much instantly get older. So. It happens, it happens. So what? Besides, what on earth is more on my favorite PC than today? It's vital that I keep that bottom part closed. I remember my strategies with the A10, man. Thank you.
gentlemen. If you don't want to spoil the ending to the game, please stop watching here. I hope you liked what you saw. If so, be sure to hit that like button. Subscribe for more retro content, ladies and gentlemen. Super Nintendo SP out!
You have a good one.
Base, but his radio is not responding.
Both of them are super worried and thinking he's dead.
If you watched Area 88, you know how close they are.
Video.
I know.
Keep old schooling it.